as you try to break a habit, I change my to break a habit.
The notion of semi-affordable Italian cars hasn't exactly gained the traction of, say, a Sotheby's noodle-craft auction. Fiat 500 sales have been bending toward freefall since that motorized espresso shot first appeared in 2011. And Alfa Romeo's mid-engine 4C sells in exotic volumes befitting its exotic looks, but it's hardly competitive with similarly priced toys. The Giulia will eventually boost Alfa's sales here by giving the brand a mainstreamish product, but repeated delays mean deliveries won't start until about the time you read this. Chassis, named for the famous Italian mountain pass that is the best driving road we've ever clogged with the tractor, the Stelvio shares its platform with the Giulia. It uses aluminum for the brake calipers, doors, fenders, front shock towers, and front and rear subframes. The control arm front and multi-link rear suspension assemblies also use the stuff. For further weight savings, parts of the rear crossmember are molded from composites. Using similar construction, the Giulia undercuts many of its competitors at the scales. We expect the Stelvio to do the same. Powertrain. This is where the Stelvio gets really interesting. The base model and the T share a direct-injected 2.0-liter four-cylinder with an aluminum block and head. A twin-scroll turbocharger and an intercooler help it generate 280 horsepower at 5,200 revolutions per minute and 306 pound-feet of torque from 2,250 to 4,500. Fiat's fuel-saving multi-air system gets employed here, ditching the throttle plate in favor of variable intake valve timing and lift, which cuts pumping losses. Styling. For a crossover based on a sedan architecture, the Stelvio looks pretty obviously like exactly what it is. The daylight opening, the body side crease passing through the door handles, and the haunches leave no doubt as to the family tie. The grille and hood appear to be the same parts that are used on the Giulia, just with different concentrations of frag DNA. But the additional cuts, bulges, and busyness along the Stelvio's rocker panels effectively mask its greater height. The quad exhaust and faux diffuser seen on these pages will be exclusive to the Quadrifoglio.